Hello, you are welcome. This is example 3 on the same topic of momentum and impulse. This example reads, a ball of mass 500 grams traveling at a speed of 10 meters per second at 60 degrees to the horizontal strikes a vertical wall and rebounds with the same speed at 120 degrees from the original direction. If the ball is in contact with the wall for 8 milliseconds, calculate the average force exerted by the wall on the ball. Okay, this is the answer. Let's see whether we get it. We interpret the question first with an illustration. The ball has mass of 500 grams moving at 10 meters per second. So let's say that this is position one of the ball. Position one of the ball moves with 10 meters per second. At an angle of 60 degrees to the horizontal, so that is horizontal line, the angle is 60 degrees. It strikes the vertical wall, that's the wall and it's vertical, rebounds with the speed of same speed, so that is going to be 10 meters per second, rebounding to position 2 at an angle of 120 from the original direction. So this statement means that from position 1 to position 2, the change in direction is 120 degrees. So already we have this at 60 degrees. So that's going to be 60 degrees, such that the angle between the original direction and the final direction is 120 degrees. Okay, if the ball is in contact with the wall for 8 milliseconds, that's going to be dealt with in our calculations. But what we need to understand for now is that consider the first motion of the ball with 10 meters per second. It strikes the wall at an angle 60 degrees to the horizontal. So that means the momentum in this case has two components, the vertical component and horizontal component, because the velocity is inclined at an angle. If the velocity was normal to the wall, then the momentum will have only one direction, that is normal to the wall. In this case, it is 60 degrees to the horizontal. Therefore, we have to first resolve the velocity. From position one here, the velocity is going to be, we'll have a component vertically upwards, which is going to be 10 sine 60 degrees. And then we have also a component to the wall, normal to the wall, which will be 10 cos 60 degrees. Then after rebound, then the ball goes with the same velocity of 10 meters per second at an angle of 60 degrees to the horizontal. So that means this component, 10 meters per second after rebounding, will also have two components. We'll have a component going upwards, which is going to be 10 sine 60, and we'll also have a component to the right, which is going to be 10 cos 60, 10 cos 60 degrees. So we have got the components. Now let's go ahead and get the change in momentum. We know that if the question wants the average force, force is the same as impulse divided by the time for which the force acts. So we have the time and we have now to look for the impulse. Impulse in this case, the other way to find it is mass times the change in velocity. In this case, change in velocity will be v final minus v initial. Okay, so again we have seen that velocity has both vertical component and horizontal component. It implies that since impulse is also a vector quantity, we'll have a vertical component and horizontal component. So let's go ahead and find impulse in the vertical component. Impulse in the vertical component will be mass of the body times the change in velocity in the vertical plane. Okay, so the change in velocity in the vertical plane, we have the two velocity components. Let's look at them. We have this velocity component, 10 sine 60, going vertically upwards, and we have another 10 sine 60 also going vertically upwards. So if they are all going in a vertical plane upwards, they are all going in a positive direction. Therefore, the change in velocity in this case would be 10 sine 60 minus 10 sine 60. And this is going to give us zero. So we get no impulse in the vertical plane because all velocity components are having the same sign, going in the same direction, having the same magnitude. Let's go ahead and get the impulse in the horizontal direction. It's mass times change in velocity. Mass is there, change in velocity is going to be, okay, let's observe the components. We have this component, which is 10 cos 60, to the left, therefore that has a negative sign. We have another component, which is 10 cos 60, to the right, therefore that has a positive sign. So since the velocity change will be V final minus V initial, V final, remember V final is a positive, so it's going to be 10 cos 60 positive minus the initial velocity, which is 10 cos 60 to the left, so that's going to be negative 10 cos 60. So of course here you see that the plus, the minus, a minus turns into a plus. Therefore, the impulse in the horizontal direction is going to be equal to, remember cos 60 is a half, so that is going to be 5, that's 10. 10 times the mass, which is given as 500 grams, but 500 grams correspond to 0.5 kilograms, so that's going to be 0.5 kilograms, and this is going to give us 5 kilogram meter per second, or the same as 5 newton second. If you want, you'd say impulse is going to be 5 newton second. That's not what the question wants. Let's look at the question. Calculate the average force exerted by the ball on the wall. Average force denoted by F, we have seen it is impulse over time. Impulse is 5 newton second, divided by the time to which the force acts, it's 8 milliseconds. So that is 8 × 10⁻³ seconds. If you feed in your calculator, you get 625 newtons. But now let's check, in which direction is this force? This impulse is 5 kilogram meter per second, or 5 newton second, but this is only in the horizontal plane. It is in the horizontal plane. So since it is the same impulse that we are using to get this force, it means that that force is also in the horizontal plane. So therefore, there is no force in the vertical plane because the impulse in the vertical plane is zero, but there is a force of 620 newton in the horizontal plane because the change in momentum, there is a change in momentum in the horizontal plane.